So you want a passphrase that is really secure, that you actually have a chance of remembering, and that you can store and back up in a way that can be resistant to common sorts of typos and mistakes. In this video, we're going to look at how to generate a passphrase using the EFF 2.0 diceware list. If you'd like to hear more about how to stay safe in the crypto space or how to recover if you make a mistake, just hit subscribe. So in my previous video, I talked about using diceware to select a secure 25th word for your BIP39 passphrase, but I didn't really talk about how. And I'd had a few questions about it, so I thought I'd just spell it out in a video. If you're not familiar with diceware, you might be asking, well, why do we use this? And the reason is so you can select a passphrase that is secure based on true entropy, that is randomness, and not just you coming up with some seemingly elaborate way to hide and obscure the password, essentially taking sort of an entropy shortcut that you think is unique and you think is original and random and secure, but actually probably isn't. The EFF 2.0 list is brilliant in that it allows you to make passphrases that are both secure, memorable, and allow you to have fault-tolerant backups. So a single typo in your passphrase won't mean you can't recover anything. So the steps for this are really straightforward. Firstly, get yourself some dice. I got some dice off eBay. It was $1 for 10. Not bad. Secondly, you need a consistent way of reading and rolling the dice that removes your subjectivity. So I'll be shaking them in this box, basically just reading them from right to left. We're going to write them down as we go. I'd suggest you do this on paper, but I'll be just doing it on the screen just so that you can see what I'm doing. And we'll be keeping track of that as we go. So on the left, I've got all the dice numbers that we rolled, and on the right, I have the EFF 2.0 list, which is basically a list of numbers and corresponding words. So we're just going to search through this list and copy and paste the word that corresponds to each number in. And we're doing all of this in a secure air-gapped tails environment because we're going to be working with a 24-word seed in a minute too. But doing it this way makes it easy to copy and paste without having to worry about making too many transcription errors. So that's what we're going to do. So we're going to take that and we're going to stick it into Ian Coleman's BIP39 tool. It's worth keeping in mind that using a full 8 words is a huge amount of entropy. So depending on your needs, something just like 6 words might be enough. One of the other really important things about your BIP39 passphrase is that it actually doesn't have any error detection or correction in it. Whereas if you type in a word that's incorrect in your 24-word seed phrase, this last word's actually a checksum and will tell you that the phrase is invalid. Whereas if you have a typo in what you've typed in here, say you haven't copied and pasted, you've just typed it by hand, you actually will not be warned about that in any way at all. So if you are doing the 100% offline 24-word seed generation and offline diceware passphrase generation, my recommendation to you is actually that you write down your BIP39 mnemonic on paper, that you write down your BIP39 passphrase on paper, that you note down the first Bitcoin public address, shut everything down, and come back a day or two later so that you can make sure that your backup, both the 24-word seed phrase and your BIP39 passphrase, is generating exactly the same first Bitcoin public address that you are expecting. Because if you get even one character wrong, say you accidentally had a space, you know, at the end of your BIP39 passphrase, you're going to get a completely different first address. It's important that you understand your brain's ability to read things and skip over things and to repeat the same mistake twice in one sitting. Whereas if you come back, a few days apart and you're still getting the same set of public addresses, then you can be confident that your backups are robust and you're ready to start depositing all your crypto. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.